Well, by any measure, Grace Tame's tenure as Australian of the Year has been one for the history books. She became an unflinching advocate for sexual abuse survivors and women across Australia, often taking her fight to the Prime Minister himself. Well, there was one final excruciating encounter between the pair today at the lodge.
If looks could kill...
And just over here, please. One, two, over here, Prime Minister. Yeah.
Outgoing Australian of the Year Grace Tame couldn't even try to hold back her disdain for Scott Morrison, and yet the PM pushed on.
Hello, Grace. How are you going? Congratulations on the engagement. Thank you very much.
Her fiancé kept his sunnies on and chewing gum in, and while there was a hint of civility for Jenny Morrison, the crushing awkwardness lingered. 20 painful seconds capped off a bitter year between the pair. A fierce advocate for survivors of sexual assault, Grace Tame roared into her role as Australian of the Year 2021.
Will not be silenced. Let's make some noise, Australia!
That noise soon aimed squarely at the PM.
Jenny and I spoke last night, and she said to me, "You have to think about this as a father first."
It shouldn't take having children to have a conscience.
Today's deafening silence spoke for itself. Scott Morrison, no doubt hopeful for a more productive relationship with whoever takes it out this year.
I've got to say, it's the pinnacle of my life, guys.
Excited, humbled, and surprised.
It's a real honour to be representing my community in Canberra.
Queenslanders Sue and Lloyd Clark among those recognised for their courage in the face of unfathomable loss.
We'd like people to stand up and not be bystanders anymore when they see coercive control happening.
From champions of the most vulnerable...
Running towards fires and floods to protect others from their property as they flee to safety. Going to work day after day to care for the sick, knowing the risk to your own health.
To sporting greats, Patty Mills and Dylan Alcott too in the running. The Australian of the Year will be crowned later tonight. Ria Abraham for 10 News First.